Welcome to On Media, the program where we discuss media's evolution and its impact to society. Today we have an interesting program for you today, folks. I brought with me three guests who each interview a person from 20 to 40 years older than them. And with the information they collected, we're going to talk about some interesting topics. So guys, why don't you introduce yourselves and tell us who you interview?
Mm-hmm. I'm Emily and I interviewed my coworker Sue. She is 66 years old.
I'm Garvin and I interviewed my Aunt Amy. She's 53 years old.
I'm Kyle. I interviewed my dad and he's 50 years old.
Thank you guys for being here. And I think when we set up this interview, one of the things we wanted to find about of our interviewers is the media consumptions they had back in their days. So can you tell us a little bit about the media consumptions of your interviewers, please?
Yeah, so she told me about a family TV that she had growing up. It was the only TV in the house, mostly used to watch the news after eating dinner, which she said she and her siblings weren't interested in anyway. She also talked about how her family only lived a block away from the Telegraph Herald, so they would always get their newspaper very early.
My aunt told me about how she got most of her news through like the news channel on the TV and also like the daily newspaper.
For my dad, growing up, he had the daily news that was on at 5 and 10 p.m. every day, and he also had the daily newspaper, and he also got magazines as well.
Thank you. And one of the things that you mentioned is that media not only lets us be informed about everything in the world, but also let us communicate to our friends and family. So could you tell us a little bit about how did your interviewers stay connected to their families and friends back in the day?
So I didn't ask Sue specifically about friends, but she did tell me how in high school when she met her husband, he had joined the Navy in their senior year. So for about 3 years leading up until when they got married, they were communicating pretty much entirely through letters and occasional phone calls, which had to be patched through like ham radio operators. So those were like very essential to their communication.
My aunt, she would stay connected with her friends and family through like the telephone
For my dad, he made plans at school with his friends, and if they didn't make plans while at school, they would call each other through the household phones and make plans that way.
Well, I'm pretty sure everybody found it interesting knowing the media back in their days, but as time goes on, new media is introduced and technology also evolves. So when I interviewed my mom and my dad, they both had positive and negative things to say about this new advancement in technology. What about your interviewers, guys?
So I had specifically asked Sue about if she felt we were missing out because of advanced technology, and she had said that we're actually very lucky to have it at this time. She talks about like her son struggling in school and like having to do research and assignments and things like that. She says like it's all in the palm of our hands, so she thinks we're very lucky.
My aunt says that there's like a lot of positives to it, but also like very many negatives to social media.
My dad kind of said something similar to that as well, just because of the fact that with all the advancements there are now today, there are negatives because a lot of times people are more having conversations on the phone rather than face to face. And that's one of the reasons he also said that our generation is missing out.
You mentioned something, a new platform that was introduced thanks to this new technology, which is social media. You know, platforms like Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, they are revolutionary because they let us stay connected with our friends, but also knowing like the events of their lives, but also receive information in a even quicker way. How do they feel about social media? And do you think it's a positive or a negative impact?
So I think Sue leans more towards negative, mostly because I had asked her if she had to cut anyone off because of disagreements over like social media platforms. She said nothing has ever gotten that far, but she is irritated when there's like big announcements or something on social media because it doesn't feel personal. Like you could have just as easily like texted or called her as you could have made that post.
I could also agree on that with like my aunt has had to like cut off her friends or like not really friends but like acquaintances that she's had because of like things they said on the internet. But overall, she said her experience with social media was pretty good.
My dad didn't say anything about cutting people off, but he did say how social media now is more negative just because there's so much out there that it's hard to know what is real and like what is not. So that's one of the reasons he said it's
Well, I'm pretty sure everybody found interesting knowing about their perspectives towards mass media, not only back in the days, but also nowadays. But what about us? When I interviewed my mom and my dad, my perspective about mass media really changed because it made me realize how influential mass media is, and especially nowadays with the introduction of AI, we can receive a lot of false information, and that false information could have a big influence on society nowadays. So that makes us tend to be a little more media literate. What about you guys? Has your perspective changed after this interview?
I think my perspective has definitely changed. I think kind of the point that Sue brought up is you're so connected now, but it just doesn't feel as personal as it used to. I like checking in on people or being able to see what's going on, but I kind of wish that there was less of it. I wasn't so connected.
I don't feel like my perspective has changed that much on like social media, but I have been able to think about it like more in depth into like what's like really going on.
I would say my perspective has definitely changed a lot. Hearing my dad say our generation is missing out on a lot made me realize that, you know, a lot of times people are having conversations over the phone, and a lot of times people are saying things that they wouldn't have the confidence to say in a face-to-face conversation.
Well, I'm pretty sure everybody of us learned something new today. So thank you so much, guys, for being here. And thank you for tuning in on media. This is everything we have for you today, folks. We'll see you next time.